Maneen Nazer is a Muslim leader, writer, and interfaith activist who is highly respected for his knowledge and involvement in religious and current affairs. Maneeb is the president of the Olive Tree Foundation, the executive director of the Cordoba Center for Civic Engagement and Leadership, and the managing editor of the online Canadian Muslim magazine, IQRA.ca. Maneeb is a frequent guest speaker at institutions where he promotes greater interfaith understanding and active citizenship.
In the name of God, the All Merciful, the Mercy Giving. Assalamu alaikum. May the peace, mercy, and blessings of God be on you. In the religious traditions, in our repetition, is seen as indispensable in deepening spiritual insight. So today, we'll be repeating much of what you'll hear today will be repeated. But I want to begin with a tradition, a saying of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be on him. He said, people who show mercy to others will be shown mercy by the All-Merciful. Be merciful to those on earth, and he who is in the heaven will be merciful to you. This saying, or this hadith of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be on him, is a perfect example of Islam's fundamental ethos, which promotes a doctrine of all-embracing universal mercy. And throughout the world, Muslim students in seminaries are taught this saying of the Prophet Muhammad, along with the full chain of transmitters which they are required to memorize. Yet, this universal, all-embracing mercy that the Prophet Muhammad spoke about is not how the religion of Islam has been portrayed. One of the biggest misrepresentations about Islam is that it says little about mercy, compassion, and love. The God that Islam speaks of is usually portrayed as only a supreme lawgiver who's outside of the world, a God who's only majesty, and never a God with us. This portrayal presents a God that loves human beings by issuing commandments, and human beings in turn love God by obeying him. In addition, in the past few decades, it has become popular to describe Islam with the slogan that Islam is peace, just as Christianity is usually characterized as a religion of love. Of course, in terms of creed, Muslims are justified in equating Islam as leading to peace, just as Christians are justified in identifying their faith with love. However, from a theological perspective, it would be more accurate to describe Islam as a religion of mercy. Pope Francis, in proclaiming the Jubilee Year of Mercy, he noted, and I quote, among the privileged names that Islam attributes to the Creator are merciful and kind. This invocation is often on the lips of faithful Muslims who feel themselves accompanied and sustained by mercy in their daily weakness, end of quote. This invocation that Pope Francis references in Arabic, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, in the name of Allah God, the All-Merciful, the Mercy-Giving, this invocation is central to the daily life of Muslims. It consecrates every act for a Muslim. In this invocation, God describes himself with two names, the All-Merciful and the Mercy-Giving, Rahman and Rahim. And these two names can be said to be the greatest names of God after Allah in Islam. And they're the most descriptive of his relation to the world. And Muslim theologians, you know, have spent a great deal of time explaining the differences between the All-Merciful and the Mercy-Giving, saying that the All-Merciful mercy is universal, it is essential. And the mercy-giving mercy is particular or attributive. This universal mercy is God's disposition towards creation, his overarching disposition towards creation that begins with the bestowal of existence. And this all-encompassing mercy is constantly flowing, reaches creation in a parental-type disposition, like a mother who will never stop loving her children. And the Quran states that God designed the world and rules his universe in this aspect of this all-encompassing mercy. The Quran says God ordained mercy upon himself. And Muslims believe that God's mercy was expressed through messengers who conveyed his revelation to humanity. The Quran describes the Quran, as well as the Torah of Moses, to be a mercy for it lights the way to God's mercy. Similarly, the Quran proclaims Muhammad to be a mercy to the world, and it proclaims Jesus to be a revelation for mankind and a mercy from us. Therefore, in the Quranic description, we're living in this universe, bearing the stamp of mercy, this all-encompassing mercy. In distinction to this universal mercy is the responsive mercy, the mercy-giving mercy. And God bestows this type of mercy based on our engagement, based on our effort, commitment, and love. And the Islamic tradition defines mercy as the intent to bring good to others, to cause benefit to others, and to avert evil. So mercy assumes this proactive dimension that seeks to set things right, to make a break with the past, to foster new beginnings where goodness and benefit can strive. And Pope Francis, in proclaiming the Jubilee Year of Mercy, is urging us to foster new beginnings where goodness and benefit can thrive, to use this Year of Mercy to engage with other religious communities, to eliminate, as he says, every form of close-mindedness and disrespect. As we encounter each other in dialogue, we realize that there are many points of convergence between our two faith communities. We both understand God to be a merciful God. And when we Muslims encounter the Christian understanding of this parent-like, merciful description of God, it resonates with us. It reminds us of the Prophet Muhammad's description, where he explains God's mercy to be that of a nurturing mother. Jesus' parable of the prodigal son, or the story of the merciful father, also resonates with us. As we read this parable, Muslims are reminded of the compassion of God, and an often reported saying of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be on him. He says that God says that if we go to him walking, he comes to us running. However, beyond this theological dialogue towards greater religious understanding, we must also seek to find mercy and encounters with each other. In his book, In the Name of God is Mercy, Pope Francis eloquently speaks about not being overly preoccupied with the law and forgetting love and mercy, advising that we should not be like scholars of law who live attached to the letter of the law but who neglect love. Men who only know how to close doors and draw boundaries, he says. So we must seek this unconstrained mercy in our encounters with each other. Today, Christians and Muslims comprise nearly half of the world's population. This relationship between our two faith communities is of great importance and significance for the welfare and future of the whole human family. We must work to deepen our encounters and build on the many excellent interfaith initiatives in this city, in this country. We must move beyond the dialogue of ideas to a dialogue of life, a dialogue of action. And these encounters must not just be passing phases, but a lifelong commitment where we share our joys and sorrows, our problems and preoccupations. The great Muslim theologian Abu Hamid al-Ghazali, he defines a compassionate relationship to the extent that we must assist each other by prayer or showing grief on account of our needs and sympathy and love towards each other, sharing in our misfortunes and our needs. Let me conclude by saying that encounters and dialogue are about the how and what in our relationships. But these should be consistent with why we must interact and encounter each other. Our why is to experience the mercy of God, to find the mercy of God in our relationships. Visionary leaders in both of our communities are defining this why. Pope Francis has defined it in this Jubilee Year of Mercy. The most prominent proponent of interfaith and intercultural dialogue in the Muslim world today, Fethullah Gulen, he teaches that interfaith relationships should be based on four things: love, mercy giving, tolerance, and forgiveness. We live in a world imprinted with God's mercy, in a world sustained by God's mercy. We are blessed by God's mercy when we are merciful to each other. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. I was intrigued by the title of our symposium today, which reminded me of my grade 11, Merchant of Venice. Shakespeare quotes, "The quality of mercy is not strained. It droppeth as a gentle rain from heaven upon the place beneath. It is twice blessed. It blesseth him that gives and him that takes." I leave you in peace. Assalamu alaikum.